guys are gonna get it. We're going here again. We're not past all these this time, bro.
I'm violating so many different laws right now. We're about to go into Special Birth. There's Special Birth right there. I'm not gonna be looking at the camera because I gotta look ahead of me. It's Epcot. Nothing is done here. Disney's never gonna punish this. Pieces of it have
a. Totally the top of today. Hey, Miles. Are you excited for Disney?
Yeah.
Disney grounds. My favorite type of thread.
Can't stop filming things today. I'm just like never done a Disney type of vlog. Oh, I really need a portable microphone. There's Nemo. It's not so bad in the morning anymore. Because
my morning. Another Samantha shirt.
Hey kiddo, we're parking your butt right here.
Stroller's going right over there. So we can go up
there. It is.
Right over there. Monorail. There's a little money. Disney tour.
So I'll just like throw a bunch of the rides. Do my thing, kind of.
Are you ready for
I'll be filming Soren. Look, Soren first. I film cues too. We're not buying any G-pluses or any lanes or whatever it's called.
Okay, I'll come back tomorrow.
Here you are, the lands! Here at the land.
I swear, I'm gonna run out of storage on my phone just by filming all this. I have no idea how much editing I'm gonna have to do for this. Alright, here we go. Soren. Come on, Aldi.
I'm coming. So I wonder if this is going to be a scary ride.
No, Soren's not scary. You're going to love Soren. Okay. He's never been on Soren before.
Yeah, I
used to not like it, but maybe my opinions will change.
Yeah,
sorry. Here my opinions will change. Here we go.
Woo!
It is.
Not anymore, Miles.
Good job.
I do this, sorry. I do this all the time.
You're second, man.
I used to ask that past the time.
Just
here we are. There's the table.
Is that all over the place?
Sorry.
It's.
There it is. Soren's up, it's about 25. Not $25. Okay, that's $9. Per person. This is bad.
Look. Trying to take a picture.
Flashes on. We're in land.
It's dark.
It's dark.
You guys can't see anything. I can't see anything either. This is fun. There's something. Oh, okay.
Thank you.
sunlight created the first living systems of our planet. One of those living systems is the rainforest, home to the most amazing concentration of life on our planet. These dense and beautiful forests cover only a tiny portion of the Earth's surface, but they contain more than half of its land and animals. Rainforests are also extremely rich in productive living systems, providing us with oxygen, food, medicine, and other elements essential to our lives. In the desert, nature has created a very different, no less beautiful, living system. And while this arid landscape may seem lifeless, it is very much alive. The plants and animals that have learned to survive in these harsh conditions make use of what little water they can find and avoid the scorching rays of the relentless sun. The American prairie once appeared as desolate as the desert, but over time, rainwater and nutrients gradually penetrated the hard surface of this land. Even the hooves of the mighty buffalo helped create a rich soil that would one day become home to the American farm. Humans have had one of the most profound effects. The need to produce food for a growing world led to the enormous use and sometimes overuse of the land. In our search for more efficient ways to grow food, we often fail to realize the impact of our methods. Discovering better ways to grow food that will assure both human and environmental well-being.
In the farmlands across America, real growth will be much common under vegetation containing natural fertilizers. We can enrich the soil without the use of chemicals. In arid regions, we're learning to produce food on desert seacoasts by developing and planting crops that thrive on salt water. In Japan, we're learning that by mixing leaves and other living materials into our soil, we can make farmland more fertile without the need for chemicals. Here at Epcot, we're learning to reduce the need for chemical pesticides by breeding and using natural products, like rainbows and moss.
There we go.
Yet still respect the needs of the land. Some of the answers are being discovered just ahead. To help us maintain these carefully controlled ecosystems, and for your safety, please remain seated in your boat at all times.
Yeah.
Welcome to our living laboratory, where scientists from Epcot and the U.S. Department of Agriculture are exploring different ways
to harvest
harvests now and into the future. The tropics are home to the greatest diversity of plants on the planet. Many of you, like papaya, bananas, cacao, coffee, and rice, are well known around the world. These are just a few of many plants that have been an important source of control for people living in the tropics. Many are rich in vitamins and minerals, while others are well adapted to growing in
I'm gonna take up all my minerals.
Some, like the watermelon, thrive in wet, swampy areas and waterways. All parts of this plant, like even the flower petals, are edible. The starchy leaves of plants have long been used in its flowers.
If this is sideways, I'm gonna die.
It is important as the bananas growing on both sides of the boat. More than 28 million tons of bananas are
consumed
in the world.
Oh no! The fish! One camera, the other one's the flash. I'm the flash.
Another innovation at work is our integrated pest management program. By populating our greenhouses with beneficial insects that prey on harmful pests like aphids and flies, we are significantly reducing our reliance on conventional pesticides. We're growing these crops using our nutrient film system. This technique precisely controls and recycles water and nutrients. With it, we can produce over 27,000 heads of lettuce a year in this one small area.
Thank you.
We're making it.
Some of our best ideas have been inspired by nature, like these fruit and vegetable trees. By growing these ground plants vertically, we can increase yields and better control diseases. These crops taste as good as they look. In fact, we serve more than 15 tons of produce from our greenhouses and restaurants here at the land every year. The future of agriculture may include innovative ideas like this vertical growing system. Plants grown in this way use a fraction of the space required by traditional growing methods. That saves water and increases production. The aquaponic system on your left combines hydroponics with aquaculture. The fish provide a natural source of fertilizer for the plants, and the plants help keep the water clean for the fish. It's another great way to produce more while using
the nation.
In our lab, FPAC scientists are working with the U.S. Department of Agriculture on a number of innovative projects. The goal of these efforts is to produce higher yielding and better quality plants. Only then will we truly be living with the land. On behalf of Walt Disney World, we hope you've enjoyed this unique journey through our living laboratories. If you'd like a closer look, then check out the behind-the-scenes walking tour. It's a chance for the whole family to get up close and personal with the plants and growing techniques in our laboratory. Please keep your hands and feet inside the boat and remain seated until the boat comes to a complete stop. These greenhouses represent just a fraction of the work being done worldwide to produce bountiful harvests for our growing population. Scientists, farmers, and even backyard gardeners are doing their part to improve the quantity and quality of foods that we all rely upon. Together, we can continue to find more ways to increase food production and protect our precious natural environment. Only then will we truly be living with the land. On behalf of Walt Disney World, we hope you enjoy this journey.
Yeah, this 15-minute journey I had here.
Then check out the behind-the-scenes walking tour. It's a chance for the whole family to get up close and personal with the plants and
I'll end this at 15 for this recording. And I'll see you guys at the Figment.
Please keep your hands and feet.
It's Journey into Imagination. with Figgy. What?
I missed you.
Alright, I'll see y'all inside.
We're about to step in. My brother just has to deal with his stroller.
Yes. On the other side. Far.
Joy is here. Joy.
Inside Out.
Yeah.
Wow.
Hate that movie. Anyway. Hot take. Hate that movie.
Imagination. Inside your torture. Keep a watchful eye on your children, and, please don't let your imaginations run wild.
Bienvenidos. Para su seguridad durante su estadía en nuestros laboratorios sensoriales, permanezca sentado y mantenga las manos, brazos, pies y piernas dentro del vehículo. Y cuide a los pequeñitos. Gracias.
People see a malfunction. A ride breakdown.
Maybe the lights will be on the entire time and there's no show audio.
Hint, hint.
I've seen that. Oh, no. Okay. Or we could have the show lights.
Welcome to our special drive-through open house. I'm Dr. Nigel Channing, chairman of the Imagination Institute. Hello. On your tour, you'll see how the five human senses can help capture your imagination.
Oh, can I go too?
Absolutely not. This is one of our discoveries, the figment of imagination.
Yeah, I know a lot about the senses. There's sight, sound, smell, touch, hoochie-coochie-go, and taste. Taste my chicken. Can I go? Please, please, please.
No, I don't want you out of my sight.
Out of sight? Okay. Come on, everybody. Here we go.
Figment, you are not to interfere with the tour.
Our first stop is the sound lab. We'll begin by testing your hearing with a series of tones. Left ear, right ear. Left, right. What? This is odd. Hello?
Hello?
Who is this?
It's Figment!
Figment? I thought I told you not to interfere.
But you've got it wrong, Doc. It's not about listening with your ears. It's about listening with your imagination.
Now I've completely lost my train of thought.
No, you haven't. It's over here. All aboard. Woo-hoo! Next stop, imagination. For every sound your ears are hearing, a thousand thoughts can start appearing, and each of us imagines different things. From just a sound, your mind has wings.
Continuing now, if I may, in a calm, scientific, figment-free manner, the things we see with our eyes can control the eyes of the imagination. Let's begin by using the eye chart to test your vision. Altogether, if you would please read line 3 and
get... With M-I-G-M-E-N-T, you can see things differently. Sure, you can see with your eyes, but imagine what you could see if you used your imagination. Follow the bouncing figment. One spark of light can light your fancy. Your mind sees more than what your eyes see. Your sense of sight can make your fancy fly. There's more to sight than meets the eye. To use your imagination, so let the good times roll! Woohoo! You win one cent!
Figment, don't!
Oh,
yeah! Really?
Of course, Doc! The nose knows!
What?
big stint in the smell lab, I hesitate to send you into the touch and taste labs. Perhaps I should end my open house right here.
Great idea. We'll go to my open house instead. It's much more fun. Right this way, everybody.
What is going on? You're turning this entire open house upside down.
Upside down? Now you're talking. That's the best idea you've had all day. With just a spark of inspiration, I made my house an innovation. Imagination really wound around. Makes down, tied up, and upside down.
Works the best when it's set free.
You said it, Doc! Imagination is a blast!
Yeah.
American temple. I mean, Mexican temple. American temple.
Oh, and I collect in this one.
Reset.
Yeah.
Time for a bunch of famous places in the world.
I forgot about that.